Resin, you want to try and use as little colorant as possible because it can affect the formula. I do tend to go overboard sometimes, but it's only affected the outcome once or twice. Oh, that's beautiful. Look at that mossy green. Indeed, very shiny. eyeshadows that are made in the theme of Firefly, which is the show that I really love. I also have Mutated Cow Fetus and Zoe's Kiss. Mutated Cow Fetus is a purple, and Zoe's Kiss is a beautiful deep red. So we'll try this one. It's just old dried resin at the bottom. Well, that's really pretty. It's like a rose. Eyeshadows make excellent resin dyes, especially powder ones. We'll set this one aside for now, and I'll show you the ones that I've made. Yet. So, this really isn't accurate of how they'll look. When they're completed. This one will be clear with gold detail, and it'll be shiny like this on both sides. This one will be a beautiful dark cream gold. This one will be dotted with sparkle, like a marble almost. This one will be a jade green. This one will be a beautiful antiqued brown. So, and then we'll have the red one. We'll just have to paint them all with resin. And then we can make necklaces out of them. Like pendants. Quite beautiful as wearable art, I think. So, this one appears to be done. You can peel it out. Try to be careful. This one, which is the first one I made, just clear with gold detail. This one that looks almost like goldstone, it glitters. They all need to be sanded on the edges, but I'm gonna do that afterwards. See how that is going to bring out the color, give it a beautiful shine, make the sparkle really apparent. I wish I had a paintbrush to do this with, but the paintbrushes, it's so hard to clean resin off of them. Avoid using one, I will. Just gotta get her nose now. Okay. Fantastic. Okay, we'll try the clear one now. This is a very dramatic change. Interest it creates to polish them like this. discovered a better polish for resin than more resin. It really is the best way to polish them. You just have to be so patient, because each layer takes between 24 to 48 hours to dry. When my grandmother passed away, she left me this beautiful collection of art supplies, and one of the things that she left me was this incredible Dremel set. It didn't come with the Dremel, but it had all the little tools, little sandpaper wheels. These are all little buffers and things. She did a great deal of woodworking, and this was one of the things she used. I haven't found a use for all of them yet. Sure what these ones are for yet. There are drilling ones and the sanding ones, all kinds of different little extensions for it. So I used one of those to cut little tiny holes in all of the after they cured. This is the green one. The sparkly one. This one's got that firefly eyeshadow shiny in it. Shiny is what they say to mean good. The red one. This one is Zoe's kiss. You can see I haven't cleaned up the holes in all of these. They need to be sort of, the plastic shavings need to be wiped away. This one is bunk. That's my cat. So I took a little bit of this wire and this tool, multi-tool. It's got a it right up. do the same on the other side. It's always a little tricky because it's so small. This is the other side of the clasp. Or hook, I suppose. Be doing the same with all the rest of them. So long. I tried making one last one, but the mold is coming apart. You can see it's stuck with the mold is sticking.